evening, everybody, and welcome to another exciting hour of America's number one wrestling television program, Mid-South Wrestling. I'm Jim Ross, and along with Joel Watts, we'll be calling the action and a tremendous card that you will see here today. Joel's one of the most action-packed hours that have ever been assembled here on Mid-South Wrestling.
No kidding, Jim. Grizzly Smith has just done an excellent job today. The first match we'll start out with is Brad Armstrong against Buddy Landell. Great match. Tim Horner against Kamala, the Ugandan Warrior. Private Terry Daniels going against the new North American champion, Ted DiBiase. And we got a really special match coming up, Jim. You want to tell them about it, six-man?
Ladies and gentlemen, the first time ever we got a six-man tag. Two midgets and a big man on each side. Plus, you'll see Hacksaw Duggan against Dr. Death right here today. And Terry Taylor defends the TV title against Hector Guerrero. It's going to be a super hour. And we're so happy that you're with us. And right now, let's go to the ring. Ring announcer Boyd Pierce is standing by with your first great match.
This event, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner, 231 pounds from Los Angeles, nature boy Buddy Landell. And across the ring, 226 and three-quarter pounds from Marietta, Georgia, Brad Armstrong. Ron West, your referee.
Your first match here on Mid-South Wrestling, Nature Boy Buddy Landell going against the former North American heavyweight champion Brad Armstrong. And as you see, he has that leg heavily bandaged, Joel, from his encounter with Ted DiBiase in that great title match up here on Mid-South Wrestling.
You know, Brad, I spoke with him earlier on. He did strain some ligaments in that knee, but Brad is such a hard trainer, and he's in such great physical condition. That kind of conditioning and his youth have helped him spring back from that injury. Brad Armstrong! He caught Buddy Landell with all that velocity and really hip-tossed him hard, and Landell feels the sting of the canvas a second time, and now a third time, Brad Armstrong with tremendous body slams. You can see Landell, he's really hurting from that. Oh, a terrific drop kick. Well, Landell wisely goes outside. That's the kind of ring savvy that Landell exhibits quite frequently. When he gets in trouble, he runs outside the ring. There he is with that psychological warfare that he does use so well.
And that drop kick certainly helped him make his decision to leave the ring. Brad Armstrong with renewed enthusiasm here at Mid-South Wrestling. A great competitor, former national heavyweight champion. From a great wrestling family, his father, of course, Bob Armstrong, a top wrestler in his own right.
Well, I think Brad's got a great philosophy, Jim. He feels that even though he lost that North American title, he's not going to get out of character. He's going to continue to strive for the top in Mid-South. He's a competitor. He's an athlete. And, you know, he knew that the referee was looking out for his best interest in the match by calling the match. He didn't give the thing up. Oh, just like he's not giving up on that armbar.
Armstrong, and obviously in tremendous physical condition here, as Joel mentioned, the strained ligaments that he received from Ted DiBiase.
Adrenaline can cure a lot of ills, and that's a mark of a great athlete, is one who can go when he's hurt. You know, Butch Reed, for a long time, wrestled on a knee that a lot of people could not have even walked on.
And mentioning Butch Reed, he'll be here with us next week, ladies and gentlemen, live right here on Mid-South Wrestling. Be sure to join us at that time. You'll also see a special look in person of the Dirty White Boys. Landell going for the elbow. Armstrong
with a flying body press, but Landell showing the strength that he possesses. Landell, you just can't shortchange him. Like Skandar Akbar said, he's one of the most underrated athletes in the Mid-South.
There's Akbar's maneuver, the camel clutch, and you can see that he has picked up something from the infamous general as Landell has the camel clutch firmly entrenched on Brad Armstrong. This is an excruciating hold.
Not only is it an excruciating hold, Jim, but it exhibits a lot of the basic fundamentals of wrestling. Right there, Buddy Landell has got the majority of his weight down in the low back portion, around the hips, and up around the head. The hips and the head are two of the most important areas in wrestling. When you control either one of those parts, you're controlling the entire body. But Brad Armstrong has gotten up to a base, and he gets out of it using that turnbuckle to his advantage. The turnbuckle is one of the Landell there being very vicious. Snapmare back into the rear chin lock.
Referee Ron West surveying the action, one of the most skilled third men in wrestling. Boy, what a tremendous hour, ladies and gentlemen, in store. Don't go away. North American champion Ted DiBiase coming up, plus the first time ever, big men, little men, six-man tag, all in this hour. Another tremendous Mid-South Wrestling Hour. Landell with a body slam. Now Landell trying to take over on Brad.
Oh, Brad wisely got out of the way of that one. Landell with that Harley Race-type knee maneuver. Goes for the elbow.
Brad Armstrong just knocked the props out of the Nature Boy. This has been a great encounter here. Armstrong now trying to take over on Buddy, and he's doing the job.
Armstrong's had enough. Oh, look at that. Wow. Landell might be sipping soup through a straw here. Oh, look at that hip toss. And Armstrong with that drop kick, well timed, perfectly placed. Armstrong is such a great athlete. Arm whip, up the second rope. Armstrong went for that flying body press and get it into the sleeper. Brad Armstrong's got the sleeper on him. One of Armstrong's specialty holds, the sleeper. He uses it as well as anybody in wrestling, and Ron West, Buddy Landell is out. Ron West calls for the bell.
Brad Armstrong victorious here on Mid-South Wrestling, and ladies and gentlemen, when we return, you'll see Kamala right after this. Gentlemen, last week here on Mid-South Wrestling, you saw a tremendous match with Kamala and Iceman King Parsons. A lot of intriguing things and controversial things ensued in that encounter. We had a Friday left, the original Friday. Sheik Hercules Hernandez came down in a Friday uniform, for the lack of a better term. It got to be very, very exciting at the end of that bout. Let's go now to last week and see exactly what happened. Iceman, he caught him a drop kick. Kamala went down. There's a second Friday out there. That's not Friday. The man's too big. Too big.
And he rolled the Iceman back into the ring.
Kamala hits him that awesome splash. One, two, three. One, two, three, and the Iceman, whose head was running the post by that other Friday. Friday's in the ring. That's not the... Kamala senses it. Look at Kamala. He senses it. Kamala doesn't know it. It's Hercules. It's Sheik Hercules.
Hercules takes off the mask.
Now the real Friday's back in there. Again, Akbar stacks the deck against the Iceman. Akbar stacks the deck against the Iceman. The Savage is confused right now. Friday's trying to get him under control. But again, the deck has been stacked. Well, General Skandar Akbar in that match was barred from ringside. You saw exactly what happened. Sheik Hercules Hernandez really took it to the Iceman. This controversial situation between the Iceman and Akbar's people is really coming to a head, ladies and gentlemen. And speaking of General Skandar Akbar and his people, let's go to the ring now. Kamala is up next.
This event, one fall or a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner, General Skandar Akbar presents at 387 pounds, Kamala, the Ugandan warrior. And across the ring, Knoxville, Tennessee, 224-pound, Tim Horner.
Referee for this match is Randy Anderson, ladies and gentlemen. As you see, the most awesome force in wrestling at this point in time, nearly 400 pounds, Kamala, the Ugandan savage, Referee Randy Anderson calls for the bell, and Joel, without a doubt, young Tim Horner is faced with the biggest test of his career.
Well, Jim, I think the favorite in this match has got to be Kamala. But, you know, the thing that strikes me, even after a week, I've been thinking about it, and I think what Hercules Hernandez did by coming down in the Friday uniform was probably one of the most heinous acts of subterfuge that one of Akbar's men had ever committed.
I wholeheartedly agree, and Akbar is... He is not above doing anything to accomplish his goals, as you see, Kamala. 387 pounds, and what a force in wrestling. And those chops could seemingly take off a tree limb.
Well, it's hard to pick out a strategy against Kamala. He's so big, and he's so massive. And one of the strange things about Kamala is that he works as well on his feet. As you can see there, even though a lot of the big men, you want to get the distance away from him. With Kamala, that's not the case. His arms and legs have so much extension and so much power. Even staying away from him and hitting him with the drop kicks is a lot of times ineffective because he's so powerful when he's on the mat and he's so powerful when he's on his feet. He is an unbelievable force.
As young Tim Horner is finding out at this point in time, Horner, though, give him credit. He's trying to fight back. And Kamala, that kick deep into the midsection of Tim Horner.
There's no doubt about it, Jim. Kamala is Akbar's main man. He's got the North American title with Ted DiBiase, his associate now. He has a lot of leverage in the Mid-South.
He certainly does. And we will see Ted DiBiase coming up in just a few moments here on Mid-South Wrestling. Oh! Kamala with that thunderous chop. There you see Friday and Akbar. I don't know how they control him. No one has figured out. Is it hand signals? Is it verbal signals? What is it that controls this big man? Last week, the look on Sheik Hercules' face, Kamala knew it wasn't Friday.
Kamala's just a savage. That's all there is to it. But you know, Iceman King Parsons, even though he suffered the defeat at the hands of Kamala last week, is not about to give up. He says he's here for a reason, not a season. Oh, and gosh, did you see that?
Kamala, he just is tremendously strong. Uh-oh. Kamala with that big splash. He was up in the air, and Tim Horner is flattened. Literally flattened.
Mass. You see, Kamala the Savage. He's instructed by Friday to turn Horner over and catch the fall. He just wants to squash, annihilate, and maim. He's awesome.
Kamala the victor, and ladies and gentlemen, you'll see the North American champion, Ted DiBiase, coming up right after this word from Mid-South Wrestling. Ladies and gentlemen, we certainly hope you were with us here last week, because if you were, you saw in the ring, I was talking with Ted DiBiase. He was all decked out from head to toe, showing us what he perceives as real class, the way he was dressed up and so forth. Great tag team match was supposed to go between Nature Boy Buddy Landell and Dr. Death against Hacksaw Duggan and Terry Taylor. Well, some wild things happened. Landell was eliminated. He went to the dressing room, and then DiBiase took his place. That match was Ted DiBiase and Dr. Death, the impromptu tag, against Hacksaw Duggan and Terry Taylor. It was quite a tremendous match. Let's go now to last week and the closing moments of that classic battle.
Terry Taylor, he's made
Look
the tag.
Look at that move.
The Hacksaw's in, and there's DiBiase. The athlete of the year against the North American champion, Dr. Death, pandemonium. Here comes Buddy Landell. Buddy Landell's back on the scene. Hacksaw Duggan back on fighting. Buddy Landale just pulled the top rope. Oh, Duggan went clear over the top. Looked like he'd hit that barricade. And Landale sticking the gut boots to him. Terry Taylor's in there all by himself against Dr. Death. And Landale has Duggan down, paying him back for that altercation earlier. DiBiase loading up that glove. DiBiase putting something in that glove. Dr. Death is really administering punishment to Terry Taylor. DiBiase comes around. DiBiase just KO'd Hacksaw Duggan. Buddy Landale fell out. Boy, this thing is totally out of control. Somebody's going to get a broken leg. Terry Taylor's fired up. Terry Taylor fired up. Oh, Terry Taylor's tripped by Dr. Death.
He grabbed him underneath the bottom rope.
Boy, the fans at home just have to follow him because I'll tell you, the action's happening so fast. DiBiase going for the figure four leg lock. DiBiase going for the figure four leg lock. The referee trying to put Dr. Death out. Duggan just dropped the big elbow on DiBiase. There go he and Doc. DiBiase's rolled up. Duggan fighting away. This is just, I've never seen a match like this. This is, Buddy Landale just hit Duggan from behind. Buddy Landale. The double arm with Duggan. He ducked it. Double clothesline. Duggan hit a double clothesline. Dropkick. Spear. DiBiase trying to reload that glove. DiBiase reloaded that glove. Duggan and Terry Taylor went. The referee went ahead and counted Landale down. DiBiase trying to sneak up on Duggan. Duggan knows he can't rush it. He knows DiBiase's got it loaded.
That was certainly a tremendous victory for Hacksaw Jim Duggan and Terry Taylor, but the interesting, several interesting parts came out of that match, and one of those things was here next week. You will see a best-dressed man in Mid-South contest. Hacksaw Duggan has accepted the challenge of Ted DiBiase, and the fans here in the television studio will determine who the best-dressed man in Mid-South is between those two tremendous athletes. And speaking of tremendous athletes and North American champions in the ring, let's go now to Boyd Pierce and our next introduction.
This bout, one fall with a time limit of 10 minutes in the red corner at 259 pounds from Omaha, Nebraska, North American heavyweight champion Ted DiBiase. And his opponent, 221 pounds from Amarillo, the Cobra Corps, Private Terry Daniels. Your referee, Carl Fergie.
One fall or 10-minute time limit, as you heard ring announcer Boyd Pierce announced the North American champion Ted DiBiase. There you see him, one of the greatest technical wrestlers that this profession has ever known. And as great, Joel, as his technical abilities are, perhaps his mind may be his most impressive attribute.
DiBiase is certainly a quick thinker in the ring and outside of the ring. I think it's important to know that last week my father said, even though he was in his tuxedo last week, the ring attire is his office attire. The ring is where he makes his living. I think not only do we have a clash of athletes, but we have a clash of values. Young Terry Daniels is proud to be an American. He loves America because of the freedom. Ted DiBiase, on the other hand, is not outspoken against America because he likes America because that's where the money is.
And he will make that money any way he can and will not stop at anything to do that.
Up into the ropes. Terry Daniels really psyched up for this bout. He, of course, is in terrific condition. He has all the athletic attributes, but he may not have the ring experience of Ted DiBiase. As a matter of fact, it's probably the truth that he doesn't have quite as much experience.
But he certainly has the fan support of our packed house here at the Irish Menil Boys Club. And I know so much motivation. Of course, Ted DiBiase went to West Texas State University, played football there. And Terry Daniels grew up in Amarillo, Texas. So he has known about Ted DiBiase's athletic conquests and abilities for quite some time, even though DiBiase has made the biggest name for himself right here in the squared circle.
Terry Daniels now firing away with a few forearms. DiBiase hit him with a right cross. Daniels, beautiful move. Beautiful, 1-2-0. Gee whiz, Terry Daniels was half a count away from pinning. Again, he's got him. Terry Daniels obviously has a great game plan figured out for this match. He nearly has Ted DiBiase, and again, he's got him. Oh, but Ted, again with that right cross, that seems to be the evening factor. Terry Daniels there with some brilliant wrestling maneuvers on Ted DiBiase. Very inspired wrestling action there, but Ted DiBiase using those subterfuges as he does so well. Again, the left fist, the right. And now Terry Daniels decides to retaliate a little bit. He's in there in the ropes. Carl Fergie calling for the break. Arm whip. Ted DiBiase realizes he's got to get on the aggressive against this young man because Terry Daniels is taking it to him.
Referee Carl Fergie is asserting himself in this match as DiBiase in a blatant chokehold. DiBiase now trying to control the tempo, and Jolas, he does so many things so well in the ring, but controlling the tempo is one of the better things that he does.
And that arm whip and the elbow. See, now he's got Daniels wrestling his match. Once he gets that little bit of momentum, DiBiase is so good at monopolizing on it. And there's that elbow off the second rope, a legal maneuver, but a punishing one as well.
Ted DiBiase now. Daniels with a drop kick, Terry Daniels.
Beautifully executed move on the part of Terry Daniels. And now Terry Daniels with the momentum, I think he might have hesitated just a little bit too long.
DiBiase, the master of the figure four. Now Daniels attempted that knee drop to no avail, and DiBiase going right to work on that, trying to go the figure four. Daniels kicks out.
And wisely so. Anybody who's known DiBiase for more than a minute realizes that he's an expert. Tremendous kick to the head of Terry Daniels. Daniels reverses the arm whip. It comes out. He's got DiBiase in a bad way right now. Come on, Terry. Terry's going up to that top rope. It'll be a DQ. If he does.
Oh! Daniels was going for all the marbles, and DiBiase moved out of the way very expertly. Daniels, what a tremendous blow he took on the canvas. DiBiase down to Boston Crab.
A painful hold, a very, very painful hold. Submission hold. Terry Daniels in the Boston Crab.
Well, Daniels came off that top rope, and man, he hit the mat. DiBiase took advantage of it. There you see the North American champion, Ted DiBiase, the winner. And we'll be back with an exciting six-man tag team match right after this.
This special event, one fall or a 10-minute time limit, first time ever in Mid-South, a six-man tag bout, big and little men on each team. Introducing first, in the blue corner, the Iceman King Parson and his team of Little Coco and Cowboy Lang. And across the ring, from New Jersey, 270-pound Jack Victory. And his teammates, Little Tokyo and Lord Littlebrook. Your referee, Ron West.
For the first time ever, big man, little man, six-man tag team action. And you're seeing it first right here on Mid-South Wrestling. Further evidence, ladies and gentlemen, of why Mid-South is the number one wrestling television program in this great country of ours. two reasons. One, the great matches, and secondly, and more importantly, all the great fans that watch us, Joe, week after week.
Well, Jim, I'll venture to guess that this is going to be a fast-paced match. If what we've seen so far is any indication, you got the midgets, and when you add the soul of the Iceman, look at them drop kicks. When you add the Iceman, you got excitement. You're talking excitement, Jim.
Iceman King Parsons, one of the most charismatic wrestlers in the country, and a tough man. He wants to. There's a tag. Now watch. The pace will quicken now.
A hip toss at Cowboy Lang. He's got Little Tokyo. He's got that R bar. Here goes Lord Littlebrook. And Little Coco stopped him. Referee Ron West, he's got his hands full with these guys. Reminds me of somebody trying to catch chickens in a farm or something. There goes Little Tokyo, Cowboy Lang up. Tokyo makes the tag. And in comes Little Coco.
Little Coco and Lord Littlebrook. One of the veteran midget grapplers going against Little Tokyo here. There you see, he gave him the knee left right to the head and hurt his knee. Little Coco with that hard noggin, look.
Arm whip.
They throw him into the second turnbuckle. His head won't reach to the top one.
Tokyo scrambling for a little help there.
There's a headbutt. The Coco butt, I would assume. High elevation, Lord Littlebrook. Littlebrook with a well-placed kick, and now there's a tag. Little Tokyo comes in as he and Little Coco, both men under 100 pounds. The six-man tag action is super, but don't forget next week you talk about tag action. The Rock and Roll Express against the Guerreros. It has been signed, and it will happen right here next week on Mid-South Wrestling. Don't miss that one. Oh!
Jack Victory.
And that was...
Now, come on, Jack. Iceman coming in to even up the odds. Iceman coming in, but Roddy West has got to keep the rules under control.
Look at Iceman. He's carrying the little guy back to his corner. Victory, that was terrible. And now Iceman, you want to go, let's go.
Victory, you picked the wrong guy to mess with in the Iceman. The Iceman throws such a punishing punch.
Oh!
Gee whiz.
There's a tag. He tagged both the little guys. Whoa! What a maneuver! That's what Victory got a little bit of his own right there.
That's fantastic. And now Victory going back after Little Coco, and Iceman throws him up for a flying body press. The Iceman's got Victory covered. One, two, and three, yes.
Oh, yeah, an exciting victory for the Iceman, King Parsons, and his two little partners. And ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back with tag team action right after this word from the exciting Mid-South Wrestling Television Network.
This tag team match, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner, 251 pounds, Atlanta, Georgia, Jake the Snake Roberts. 260 pounds from Bad Street, Sheik Hercules Hernandez, along with General Skandar Akbar. And across the ring, 221 pounds, San Antonio, Texas, Shawn Michaels. At 219 from Alabama, Jason Walker. Your referee, Randy Anderson.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, this should be a dandy. Akbar is well represented, I guess. Wait a minute. Here's the Iceman. Iceman King Parsons has got a big, and I mean a big, leather strap.
The Iceman's in the ring now. We're scheduled to have a tag team match, but the Iceman is challenging.
He wants the Sheik. Look at that. He wants the Sheik to have a strap match right here. Iceman said, I've been whipped and I've been ran him into the post.
Well, he certainly got a score to settle with Hercules Hernandez. That's no doubt about that. Boy, I'd love to see Hernandez get in on this one.
Whoa! Oh, my! Well, I tell you, I don't know what... This is a time bomb. Did you hear that leather pop? Ladies and gentlemen, we'll try to figure out what's going on. We'll be right back. We'll be right back with Hacksaw Duggan against Dr. Death, and we'll have that right after this.
This event, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner, at 276 pounds, from Oklahoma University, Dr. Death, Steve Williams. And his opponent coming to the ring at 274 pounds from New York State, Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Your referee, Carl Ferguson.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be, in my prediction, an old-fashioned slobber knocker. That's what they call it in the Big Eight, and that's what it's going to be. Two great athletes, no doubt about it, world-class athletes right here on Mid-South Wrestling. And as they say, you ain't seen nothing yet because the TV title, Terry Taylor against Hector Guerrero, still yet to come here in this hour of Mid-South Wrestling.
And fans, if you just joined us, you're getting ready to see a great match, but you missed a few beforehand, and I don't have time to talk about it because this one here is probably one of the greatest battles that Mid-South Grizzly Smith has done a terrific job in signing these two men for the match in combination with all the great matches we've had so far. What a day this has been. Arm whip into the turnbuckles, Dr. Death. Dr. Death feels the sting of the canvas, and Hacksaw Duggan catches it with an elbow. Duggan goes to the well once too often. Dr. Death has become a great strategist in professional wrestling. And if ever there was a feud between two wrestlers, I don't know which is hotter, the feud between Dr. Death and Duggan or the feud between DiBiase and Duggan.
Great deal of animosity between all three of those athletes, no doubt about it. And here's two men that pride themselves on not only their great condition, but their athletic background, both former great college football players. Hacksaw Duggan, of course, at SMU. Steve Dr. Death Williams, the University of Oklahoma, both of them with great professional football backgrounds. Both of them an amateur champion. It's all there, and it's all right here on Mid-South Wrestling.
Duggan came off those ropes with a lot of velocity. Steve Dr. Death Williams wisely got out of the way. Steve apparently has the momentum early on here in the match. He's being very aggressive. Coming off the ropes, and Dr. Death catches Hacksaw Duggan with a vicious elbow. But Duggan's down. Steve Dr. Death Williams has really come into his own. He may show us something here on the Mid-South today.
Well, I'll tell you what, he has shown us a great deal from every week since he has made his debut here. Look at him on the second rope.
Now, what's he doing? He's going for that high-risk move, and Duggan, that was the break he needed. I think Dr. Death underestimated Hacksaw Duggan and just how badly he had him beaten down to that point, because that second rope maneuver was the wrong thing to do, and that gave Hacksaw Duggan the break he needed. There's that clothesline. Hacksaw Duggan now. Hacksaw Duggan with the momentum, and he's closing in on Williams. He's closing in on him. There's a lot of hatred brewing here. Former friends, former training partners, both men, tremendous collision. Hacksaw Duggan on the floor, Dr. Death on the floor. Carl Fergie with a 10 count. Carl Fergie counting both men down. Dr. Death, the men need to get back in the ring before they continue this wrestling match.
Duggan just rammed Dr. Death's arm right across that steel. Dr. Death's arm may be broken, and if it's not broken, he may be indeed the toughest man. Dr. Death's arm was hammered on that steel, and Duggan's got the pin.
Duggan got him with a quick spear. Duggan got him, and he's the winner. Duggan's the winner, and Dr. Death is writhing in pain.
Hacksaw Jim Duggan, the winner of Dr. Death. He very well could have a broken arm, and ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back. The television title will be on the line after this word from Mid-South Wrestling.
This event for the Mid-South Television Championship, one fall or TV time remaining, in the red corner at 224 pounds from Mexico City, the challenger, Hector Guerrero. On the outside of the ring is brother Chavo Guerrero. And his opponent, the Mid-South Television title holder from Vero Beach, Florida, Terry Taylor. Your referee for this title match, Ron West.
Interesting development here, Joel. Chavo Guerrero is there at ringside, apparently to second his brother in this very important television title matchup.
Well, Hector Guerrero asked for a shot at the TV title, and it seemed to outrage Jake the Snake Roberts. Jake the Snake seems to feel that, he told me that he's going after the TV title first because he thinks it's going to be the easiest title to attain. Now, I don't know if I agree with him on that one, because Terry Taylor is certainly a fine, fine athlete. Both men using those ropes. Nice move by Taylor. Nice move by Taylor. I've never seen that done before. Taylor with that great, great mind that he possesses. Excellent ring tactician, two arm drags, and Hector Guerrero is begging for mercy. But that was just a psychological ploy there, Jim. As we've seen, the Guerreros are so fine at producing. Guerrero with that punishing leg drop.
The Guerreros have quite a wide offensive arsenal that you're seeing Hector demonstrate here.
Nice move by Taylor. Nice move by Taylor. He got those knees up just in time. High elevation. Oh, Taylor. Taylor firing away now. Taylor's got the momentum. Taylor loves that TV title.
Oh, no. Chavo Guerrero tripped Terry Taylor. The ref. Hector got in the referee's way, and Chavo Guerrero on the outside. Now Chavo, Hector with a spinning leg lock, and wait a minute. Here comes
the fans.
Rock and Roll Express.
You're gonna hear the fans, the rock and roll. They're going after Chavo Guerrero. Ronnie West goes for a disqualification. There's too many men in the ring. Ronnie West with a disqualification, and rightly so. And rightly so.
Let's keep our cameras right here. The Rock and Roll came down to second. Their friend, Terry Taylor. We've got a disqualification here.
I love it. It's just great when good friends can stick up for each other like that. Chavo Guerrero using that subterfuge from outside of the ring. He came there to second Hector Guerrero.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that was tremendous excitement. The Guerreros, we've been notified, have been disqualified. Ronnie West has rendered that decision. Ladies and gentlemen, right here next week, you'll see Hacksaw Butch Reed live. You'll see the Rock and Roll Express go against the Guerreros next week. Don't forget, you'll also see the big Who's the Best Dressed Man in Mid-South. Is it Hacksaw Duggan, or is it going to be Hacksaw Duggan or Ted DiBiase? Right now, let's take a special look at the Dirty White Boys. We're going to close our program with that for Joel Watts and Boyd Pierce. I'm Jim Ross saying thanks so very much for being with us. We'll see you next week, everybody.